Hi, I'm George at StudioBinder, and today we're going to talk about your production calendar and specifically how to use the group feature. The group feature is a way of nesting events together. So once you've created a whole bunch of different events on your calendar, with the group feature, you'll be able to push them together and collapse them so you don't have to see everything all at once. Let me give you a look so you can understand more about what I'm talking about. So I already have a populated calendar here for us to take a look at. And there are an awful lot of events here. And you can see these events do not have a group bucket they belong to. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go over here and we're gonna click on Add Group. Now we wanna name our group. Do pre-production, production, post-production. Let's just keep it simple. Click Add Group. Now this pre-production group, it's essentially a folder. And what we'll do is we'll take some of these pre-production events and we'll drag it into the pre-production bucket. We'll use the words group and folder or bucket interchangeably. Now, as you can see, it's in there. And when we drag it out, it will reflect the amount of days that the event occupies. Let's just keep it where it was. And now let's say we want to put all these other events in. So this petty cache event will go in. And suddenly, our pre-production section is gaining more events. So now all our pre-production events are in the pre-production bucket. And if we close it, there you go. So you can collapse it down, and we could even collapse the post-production bucket down. And now we're only looking at this production period on the timeline, but of course the other ones are still there. They're just hidden. And another cool thing is the auto update here. So the 23-day period, the 47-day period. That's a great way that it just keeps track of how long everything's gonna take. And what's great about this is it really helps your production calendar double as a presentation. So say you wanna go into a meeting with a client or an executive and show them your calendar. It's a nice looking calendar, but the view can be clear and clutter-free, and you can emphasize certain parts of it. Like say you only wanna talk about pre-production, just go to pre-production and you can show them exactly what you're talking about. And that's all it takes to start using groups to bucket events in your production calendar. Next time, we're gonna go over what happens when you have multiple projects on your slate and you still wanna maintain the same clarity in organization. As always, hope this was helpful to you. Let us know what you thought or if there's anything else you'd like to see us go into more detail on. Of course, check back soon for more videos like this one. Thanks so much.